Hello, C++ programs, conditions and calculations. Now here is a question and the written program in front of you. Write a program to input the price of one coffee mug. In a school event, n number of students were taking part, where everyone would get a coffee mug as a gift. Input the price of one mug and the number of students. Calculate and print the total budget that will be needed. So, do you know which operation has to be done? Well, is it multiplication? Yes. Now we need what to multiply with what. As maths support the knowledge, it is supposed to be number of students into the price of one coffee mug. Now you supply those numbers, I tell you the result. This is why we will need to ask. Ask means input. Enter the price of one coffee mug, let it be PM, and enter the number of students, let it be NS. So the total budget or total price would be PM into NS. These variables have to be declared and the result has to be printed. Now let me show it in a program form of C++. So, let me now run the program and show you how the code is working, right? Compile. If I compile, you will see, well, there is no error. So, what is the code doing? Clear screen will clear the screen. Getch will ask you to wait. We'll just see the program output and then we'll go back to the program screen. Then, enter the price of one coffee mug. Enter the number of students. This is Cout with the output cascade symbol. This is C in with input symbol, right? So C out symbol, C in symbol, right? Then the total price as you have done before and the printing of the budget. So now let me run the program and show the output also. What is the price of one coffee mug? Let it be rupees 50. How many students are there? Okay, let it be 12 this time. So what will I get? Okay, 50 into 12, which is 600. And enter any key, you can see that before there are two new lines appearing, like there's a gap of two lines, and after 600 there is also, it is in the next line. So it is because I have done this thing here. What is the thing? Entering the prices, and then after printing the total budget, you see there is a new line end L, and this slash N also means new line. If I do not give these two, what will happen? You will see. Let me run the program once more and show you what will happen if I do not give those slash n. You may re-watch the video. So this time, let the price of one coffee mug be rupees 125 and let the number of students be, okay, let it be 50 students for this event. So, total budget needed is rupees 6250 coming from the product. But, where is the enter key? Enter any key to continue or enter any key? See, it has come back two lines up because of I remove all of the two slash n's. If I run the program once again with removal of this end L, you know what will happen? Let us run and see what happens. So I'll compile and then I will run. If I run, okay, this time once more, let the coffee mugs be 75 rupees this time and let the number of students be 20 this time. So, oh my God, enter any key has come on the next to the output. Do you know why? It is because there is no new line also, there is no end L also. Okay, so it's better you see this video once more to figure out, okay, what is happening where. Okay.